From Madhya Pradesh, we are shifting our focus to the northeast. Just when it seemed that the situation in Manipur was beginning to somewhat come under control, tensions have flared up once again. The Manipur government has now declared the entire state as a disturbed area under the Armed Forces Special Powers Act. This after protests over the killing of two students. The disturbed area status will continue for the next 6 months, starting October 1st, except in 19 police stations. And these 19 police stations include Imphal. Now, here's what the term disturbed area means. A disturbed area under the Armed Forces Special Powers Act will allow security and armed forces personnel to search, arrest, and open fire if deemed necessary for the maintenance of public law and order. The developments are coming just after a fresh round of protests over the kidnapping and brutal killing of two students by suspected armed men in Imphal. Yesterday, scores of students had taken to the streets, marching towards Chief Minister N. Biren Singh's residence after the pictures of the students' bodies emerged on social media. There they are. This photo went viral within days of the government lifting the nearly 5-month ban on mobile internet services. As a result, the government has now reimposed the internet ban in the state for the next 5 days. Today, again, hundreds of students marched towards the Chief Minister's residence. This happened, as I said, for a second day. Meanwhile, the government is saying that a CBI team led by a special director has now landed in Imphal. Listen in to the Chief Minister.
तो कल एक वायरल वीडियो आया, पिक्चर आया कि वो दोनों का डेड बॉडी का फोटो दिखा के, तो उसी से थोड़ा स्टूडेंट बॉडी लोग यहाँ पे थोड़ा ह्यू एंड क्राई कर रहा है, क्योंकि हम लोग भी है, नॉट ओनली द स्टूडेंट बॉडी, हम लोग भी बहुत आफ्टर वो सीन देखने के बाद में हम लोग को बहुत दुखी हुआ है और हाईली कंडेमनेबल एक्ट है. इसलिए आज लेकिन लकी बात यह है कि गृह मंत्री जी अमित शाह जी ने तुरंत कल ही शाम को मेरे को टेलीफोन करके बोला कि तुम चिंता मत करो, सब प्रजा को भाषण दो, विश्वास दो कि हम कल ही स्पेशल डायरेक्टर सीबीआई भेज रहा है उसके टीम के साथ. तो होते हुए आज नून में आ गया.
लगभग 5 महीने पहले मणिपुर में हिंसा का माहौल प्रारंभ हुआ और इस विगत 5 महीनों में आज तक भी प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी मणिपुर जाने का निर्णय नहीं लिया. और कितना सबूत चाहिए और कितना प्रमाण चाहिए कि किस प्रकार से मणिपुर की सरकार, मणिपुर की मुख्यमंत्री विफल रहे बच्चों को बचाने के लिए, महिलाओं को बचाने के लिए.
डॉक्टर मालमेल Nengthia Jao is a historian. He's also a democratic rights activist joining us on the broadcast. Ash Chatosh is a senior journalist joining us on the broadcast as well, someone who's been tracking the story in Manipur for the last 5 months. Dr. Malem, I'm going to come to you first and ask you a very simple question. We've just heard, from the Chief Minister of Manipur, embattled, because for the last 5 months, he has not been able to control the situation on the ground. Here he is stepping out today after students in their uniforms marched to his house and clashed with security forces for a second day. Here he is stepping out and saying that the Home Minister of the country has told me all will be well. Just tell the people of your state that a CBI team has now arrived in the state. How will a CBI team arriving in the state of Manipur control the situation there?
See, the demand of the protest today and yesterday were about the arrest of the culprit responsible for the cold-blooded murder and of the two students, as you pointed out. You need the corrections here. The incident of murder, kidnapping, did not happen in Imphal. It happened somewhere, an unknown identified place, but according to police report and intelligence reports, there were this incident of kidnapping and murder happened somewhere in a village called Zauzangtek Kuki village, somewhere in the peripheral hill districts. This needs to be corrected. So the protest exactly was that these culprits responsible and the miscreants responsible for the incidents be arrested and punished according to the law. So when the chief minister said, come out and said that everything will be controlled, he might have been believing that with the arrival of the CBI, the case will be, you know, taken up in a more stringent and a faster manner, and obviously the culprits may be bought, may be identified and booked. That must be the prison sense that he was saying. It's not about controlling the entire situations happening in Manipur since the third month in a day or two. But he was responding to the specific demand and the specific issues raised yesterday by students, and he was responding to that.
Fair point. Ashutosh, can I just get you in? We have Dr. Malem just explaining to us what the chief minister might have meant, because there is a specific demand of these students. But, you know, in any case, given the internet ban, Ashutosh, in Manipur, it's not like we have been getting too many pictures or too many stories coming out of the state, A. But if my memory serves me correctly, and I've looked at the Manipur story as it has developed very closely, this is the first time I'm seeing students in uniform march on the streets of capital Imphal, march towards the chief minister's house, and face the law enforcement, face the police, face the face security personnel that we are seeing on our screens. There are tear gas shells that have been fired today as well. To me, this is a clear indication that in the last 5 months, you may want us to believe that things in Manipur have gone back to normal. The fact is, things in Manipur have not gone back to normal.
So yeah, the unfortunate part is that how many viral videos and the pictures you need to believe that situation is really grim and serious and it's dangerous. How many viral pictures you need to realize, the central government need to realize that this chief minister is good for nothing and he has to be removed. These are the pictures which are rarely coming out. There must be n number of other incidents which we are not aware of. We are not even getting to know about it. The fact of the matter is, when the entire country is outraged, but the Manipur chief minister is sitting happily, and he's happy that the home minister has called him up on this particular issue. So who is going to take the responsibility when Manipur is burning? The Manipur is a classic case where even the army is being blamed for the by the police. Where the Editors Guild of India has been booked by the Manipur journalist. So the issue is much deeper, much serious than what we presume. I think this is clearly a case where this chief minister need not to be there as the chief minister. The center should have acted long back, should have sacked the chief minister, should have taken the reins of the government in their hands, and should have controlled by now. Now, how many dead bodies you need to realize that the state government has totally failed? And for that matter, central government cannot absolve itself from any other responsibility. They are also equally to be blamed.
Dr. Malmel, is it your sense as well, given the fact that you have friends and family back home in Manipur, that the real picture of Manipur and what is happening in Manipur is not coming in full view, in full public view of India, and the fact that the chief minister of the state has been completely incapable of controlling, yes, what was a complex issue, but it has already been 5 months. 178 people have already died. 34 people are already, you know, already missing. How much more worse do you need it to be, you know, for this chief minister to be sacked?
Is the question to me?
Yes, Dr. Malem, the question is to you.
We are less concerned about this, who should lead the government, because we know whenever the Manipur government come into being, it's at the mercy of the Delhi government. So it doesn't matter whether one chief minister is there or is replaced or she is replaced or whosoever comes to power. We all think that the central is fully responsible for all these crises. It's the system that is completely moribund, and the system is responsible for that. Maybe for that, for things to change sense, I think even in India, we need a people's mass democratic movements to bring a systems where, you know, it's more human and more economic and more political in that sense. So like You know, dealing with the syndrome is not going to solve the problem. Rather, there has to be a complete structural transformations based on the principles of social equity, economic equity, and all, and so on and so forth. Like, it's going to be a long journey for all of us.
Okay. Okay, Ashutosh, my last question to you. Once again, today we are hearing from Gaurav Gogoi and from the Congress party about the Prime Minister not finding the time to go to Manipur. How will the Prime Minister going to Manipur really improve the situation on the ground?
The Prime Minister is going to Manipur or not going to go Manipur? Is he willing to take a stand? Is he willing to realize that the state is burning? Is he willing to realize that the army is targeted? There is a war between the army and the police. There is a war between the two tribal communities. It's a totally bizarre, abnormal situation. So whether the Prime Minister is going or not, it's not important for me. What is important is whether he's willing to decisively act and control the situation. If the Chief Minister has failed, which everybody knows, then why he is not imposing Article 356 and sack and take the reins in his own hands? There was some mystery about invoking Article 355. The advisors were sent over there, but there is no clarity. If Article 355 was invoked, that means the center has taken the control in his own hands. But that is again not neither here nor there. The issue is that central government is not willing to put his neck out and to tell the whole world that they are taking the responsibility and they are willing to control the situation. People are dying. Can you imagine in any other state, the armories are looted? And the boxes are put in the market that if you have looted the arms, please come and deposit them. I will not punish you. What kind of situation is this? That means the state has ceased to exist in this part of the country. And when the state has totally withdrew in the buffer zone, the people are storming at the army itself. And there is a fire against the army. Now, how bizarre this can be! I have never heard that the army is being made responsible by the state and others. You are responsible for the crisis over here, and the state is just looking the other way.
Yeah, the whole point is that I don't think India right now can look the other way. The fact is that Manipur has continued to burn for 5 months, and every now and then, just when we start thinking that the situation is under control, something happens which tells us that things are not completely under control. And as I said, it's been 5 months. And as I said, more than 178 people actually have already died in the violence in the state. We'll leave it there for the moment. Dr. Malan, thank you very much. Ashutosh, thank you very much for joining us on a very, very important story that I think all of us need to speak about. Let's move on.